Konnichiwa. Today, we're going to talk about adjectives. Now, Japanese adjectives are not the same thing as English adjectives. As we know, Japanese sentences come in three fundamental kinds, depending on the kind of engine they have. We have the U train, verb sentences, the DA train, noun sentences, and the E train, which is the so-called adjectival sentences. But the truth is, that any one of the three kinds of engine can be used like an adjective. So let's start off with the most obvious one, the one that's called adjective in English. A simple E-train sentence is Pen ga akai. As you know, akai doesn't mean red, it means is red. Now, we can turn this black engine white and put it behind the pen. Now we have Akai pen ga. Akai pen means is red pen, or as we say in English, red pen. As you see, this isn't a full sentence in itself anymore, because a white engine doesn't pull the train. It just tells us more about whatever it is sitting behind. So akai, once it becomes a white engine, is just telling us more about the main car of the sentence, which is pen. And if we want to make it into a full sentence, we have to have a new engine. So, let's take chiisai, which means still small. Akai pen ga chiisai. The red pen is small. So, that's simple enough. Now, let's look at verbs. Now, if you're worrying about na adjectives, as they're called, don't worry. They are nouns, and we'll get to them in a minute. Any u engine, any verb, in any tense, can be used like an adjective. So, we can say, 少女 が歌った. 歌った means sang. The word for sing is 歌う. So the ta form, as we know from our last lesson, is 歌った. 少女 が歌った. The girl sang. And if we turn that engine white and put it behind the girl, we have 歌った. 少女. The girl who sang. And of course, once again, this isn't a sentence, but we can put it into any sentence we like, such as 歌った少女 が寝ている. The girl who sang is sleeping. And this is terribly important because a lot of Japanese is structured this way. We can use entire verb sentences as adjectival if we want to, and this happens very often. For example, 犬が 辞書 を 食べた. The dog ate the dictionary. We can turn this around to 辞書 を 食べた 犬, the dog who ate the dictionary. Or we can say 犬が 食べた 辞書, the dictionary that was eaten by the dog. And then this can build into a full sentence. 辞書 を 食べた 犬が 癒しちゃった. 癒しちゃ is a noun that means naughty or bad. So the dog who ate the dictionary is bad. This brings us to the noun engine. If we just say 犬が 癒しちゃった, we have a simple noun sentence. But we can turn this engine as well into a white engine and put it behind the dog. But there's one change we have to make. When we turn da or des into a white engine, when we connect it to anything, it changes its form from da to na. So we say 犬が 癒しちゃった, but we say 癒しちゃな 犬. Which is the same as saying 癒しちゃった 犬 is bad dog. The dog that is bad, the bad dog. So we can say 癒しちゃな 犬が 寝ている. The bad dog is sleeping. Now the important thing to note here is that you can't do this with every noun. There are only some nouns that are frequently used in an adjectival way that you can use in the way we showed here. These are what the textbooks call na adjectives, and it's a slightly confusing term because, as we see, they are in fact nouns. But they are a certain class of noun. Can we use other nouns as adjectives? Yes, we can. But we use them in a somewhat different way, and they aren't engines. To explain this, we have to introduce a new type of car for our train. And this is the no car. No is a very simple particle because it works exactly like apostrophe S in English. So, sakura no doresu means sakura's dress. Watashi no hana means my nose. Luckily, we don't have to worry about things like my and your and her and his in Japanese. We always just use no. Now, because no is the possessive particle, it can be used in another slightly different way. At the beginning of my older videos, I always used to say,
Kawajapa no kyodori desu.
I am Kawajapa's kyodori. In other words, Kawajapa is the group or party or website that I belong to. And we can use this more widely for defining the group or class to which anything belongs. So, akai means is red because we can turn the noun aka into the adjectival form akai. But we can't do that with all colors. For example, pinku, iro. Iro means color, and we say pinku iro, that means pink, but that doesn't have an I form. And it doesn't count as an adjectival noun, a na adjective as they're called in English either. So what we do with it is we use no. Pinku iro no doresu, pink dress. And this means dress belonging to the class of pink things. If we want to say Oscar the rabbit, we say usagi no Oscar, which literally means rabbit's Oscar. And what it means is Oscar who belongs to the class rabbit. Zelda no Densetsu means the Legend of Zelda. Densetsu no Senshi means legendary warrior. Warrior who belongs to the class of legendary things. So we have four ways of forming adjectivals. The three engines plus the no car. And using this, we can make all kinds of sentences, and they can become very complex, especially with verbal adjectives, in which we can use whole complex sentences in an adjectival manner. And I'm going to do some worksheets that will help us to get used to some of those more complex sentences, and I'll put them in the information section below this video lesson. Now, one thing you may be thinking is, since some nouns are used as adjectives with na and some with no, do I have to start learning lists of which ones go with no and which ones go with na? And my answer to that is, I don't see any good reason to do so unless you're having to learn them for an exam. Why not? Well, look at it logically. If you hear someone use them with either no or na, you're going to know what they're saying. If you use them yourself and you get it wrong, nobody is going to have any difficulty understanding what you're saying, and it's a very small and typical foreigner's mistake, and frankly, I think it's the least of your worries at an early stage. If you're writing, you can of course look them up very easily. As you use Japanese more, hear more Japanese, read more Japanese, you will pick up which ones are no and which ones are na. And if you're not going to use Japanese very much, well, why do you need to know? To me, Japanese isn't a game of learning abstract information for no particular reason. It's a language that, for the most part, we can learn in a natural manner, and understanding its real structure helps us very greatly to do that. If you have any comments or questions, please put them in the comments below, and I will answer. I'd like to thank my Gold Kokeshi patrons and all my patrons on Patreon for making these lessons possible and helping us all to unlock Japanese. これからも、よろしくお願いします。Class dismissed.